Bro, it's the 9-year anniversary and we got a dev note. Is this like halfway Christmas or some shit? Like, I'm pretty excited. And overall, I think this dev note is pretty positive. Yeah, I know it's late. Here's the video.
All right, best bud. Let's show these fools you can sing. Bet you fools don't have a singing, talking dog. He's really good. Are you mad I can dance too? Come on, bro. Don't be mad. Overall, I like this dev note. I like them communicating with us. They're building excitement. I'm excited. I'm excited every anniversary, and this is the 9-year. I like that they're thanking us. I appreciate them, you know, reaching out and trying to communicate to the whole community and, you know, listen to us as well as make improvements on the game. Every update, I am excited for quality of life improvements and ways that the developers can make playing the game easier for us all, from the highest level player to the lowest level player. So Otherworld Battle, I think, is a hit. I love that game mode. I like the 5 character teams, and I like the buff system. I hope that they add more stuff to the buff system. I'm looking forward to adding, you know, more combination teams or even thematic 5 character teams. The extra swords, I think that thing's great. The more buffs that help agents clear content, the better. So the new heroes, I think they've been doing a great job. They've dropped a lot of heroes over the past year, and I'm looking forward to more heroes this year. We're getting new bosses. I think that's pretty cool. I want the heroes to be tier 3 or transcendent potential. And to be honest, while we're talking about transcendent potential, I think transcendent potential should be strictly for tier 2 characters. And then tier 3s get their tier 3. I'm sick of the 30-second cooldown time. It's ridiculous. Stop with the transcendent potential. Just give everyone tier 3. King the Conqueror as a World Boss Legend and Black Swan as World Boss Legend Plus are great. I'm excited to push Black Swan further, but right now my current focus is pushing the rest of the World Boss Legends to stage 99. Overall, I'd say the Tier 4 support upgrade missions were a hit. I used all 5. I did Star-Lord and Gamora to complete the Guardians team-up collection. Then I did Cyclops, Mystique, and Sharon Rogers. I found it helpful with the discounted rate. It helped me throw the rest of those materials on native tier 2s like Gladiator and Beta Ray Bill. I hope everyone's taking advantage of the tier 4 support missions and pushing their tier 4 tunes, pushing their world boss levels, building their conqueror level up. Really, there's something to be said about pushing past level 50 on those world boss legends, because then you can get all those free mighty CTP drops. I don't know about you, but I'm always going to be excited for new content and them telling me that they have new content in development. I think they're doing a great job here trying to juice us a little bit and build some hype for stuff they got coming in the pipeline. When these fools started talking about a fun of collecting, like a collectible growth content, I immediately thought of Archive. And you know how much I love Archive. My homeboy Brennison, he's like got me beat on that. But I'm at like 94%. I'm gonna finish soon. Hopefully this year I finish it. I'm really excited about another Archive type thing. And I hope you guys are too. And this new multiplayer content, which sounds like it's like a endless mode blocking waves of enemies, I've kind of been asking for that. I kind of like low-key asked them to change World Event into like an endless mode, or even do like Shadowland into like a Shadowland Legend mode, where it's just endless waves of enemy, and you just you dump your whole roster. You start your roster, and then it goes through your roster until all of them are dead. Them working on the PvP content is such a great idea, and I'm glad they decided to tell us that. I think we've all been wanting them to work on the PvP game modes. Timeline Battle has needed work for a long time. People are doing videos on Timeline Battle constantly about what it needs fixed and whatnot. Marine Velvet, he does a lot of Timeline Battles. I think Lucifer, he also does a bunch of Timeline Battles. Anyone that I missed, I'm sorry. But thank you all for doing the Timeline Battle videos. They're great. Keep doing them. Now, you know that I love Otherworld Battle because it's a five-character team and it's got the buffs and you can move the team placement around. But what's really cool is that they're working on this game mode so soon and they're telling us about it. I think the communication here is great. I like that they're working on a game mode so soon. I appreciate that they're going to work on Alliance Conquest. We've all been asking for them to work on Alliance Conquest. It needs a lot of love and all of us play that. It takes a lot of time to play that game mode. There's three phases. They're like 2 hours long. It goes Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and then into some of Tuesday morning. The PvP content stat adjustments do kind of worry me, as they should worry anyone because they're messing with our stats. But I'm pretty confident that they're going to figure it out, and with our help, we'll be able to give them the right feedback to make it good for all of us. So I'm not too worried, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be a bit of a mess when it first comes. I think it's great that they're sticking to that poll, minus the War Machine debacle. I don't think anyone voted for that. I didn't vote for it. If you voted for it, comment on the forum, comment on my video, let me know. I haven't met anyone or talked to anyone that voted for War Machine yet. I look forward mostly to Null and Sentry, Apocalypse, and Doctor Doom as far as out of that list off the top of my head. The live stream, I think it's great that they're doing live streams, and for them to bring in someone from Marvel says a lot, and it should say a lot to you and about this game, that maybe the game's probably not going to shut down for quite some time, and maybe we get another 5, 10 more years out of this game. And you know, their little goodbye at the end I think is great. Overall, I think this whole dev note was great. Great overall tone, real positive, real hopeful, at least in my eyes. I'm still excited about this game. I know there's others that share my excitement. I'm also a realist, so you know, I expect there to be, you know, some problems just like with any live service game. But overall, I expect positive results, and I think this 9-year anniversary is going to be a banger, and I look forward to catching the live stream. Thanks for checking out my video on the dev note, everyone. 3 taps. Cheers. Never going to give you up, baby. Love you, Marvel Future Fight.
You're my favorite Barbie collection. Oh, yeah.
And as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, enable all notifications to all, and leave a comment below so I know what you think. And don't forget to leave a comment on the forum too. And yeah, if you can come into work on Sunday, that'd be great. Yeah, that's it.